10, 5, 6.
Jiva to me is to move any way my body wants to.
People assume that being a dancer is easy.
Jiva, Jiva.
You know, like it's a hype thing.
The world needs to know what dance is, Umlazi.
My body's so sore.
Yeah!
Because we're tired, I think.
That's yeah.
Just simply that.
As a South African, music and dance is our life. Jiva to me, it's not just another series, you know, I was gonna be working on.
We haven't had this. You know, we've had other dance movies and stuff, but this feels bigger.
I feel like it's very important because now we get to tell the Kasi stories. You know, we've seen Beyonce tap into the spantula thing. We've seen Chris Brown do the guara guara. So we see the biggest American artists doing what we have.
And I'm so proud to be able to be the one to tell it and to not have someone who knows nothing about it to tell it. That's what it means to me, being a Black woman from Africa telling this story to the world.
Hey, Nicola,
what are you? When you like this?
I
am traveling with ghetto women.
My name is Nicola Zamini. I play Ndongi. My love for performing started at a very young age. I want to say when I was in grade 3, but it could have been sooner.
This angle is probably terrible.
I don't look cute.
When I head downstairs, and I'm gonna see everybody.
Good morning, though. It's a brand new day.
I'm Snae Mbata, and I'm playing the role of Uzinki. I don't like to say that I'm playing Uzinki. I am Uzinki.
My name is Candace Mudisele, born, bred, buttered in Johannesburg, South Africa. Now assuming and playing and immersing herself in the role of Miswa.
My name is Given Stierman. My character name is Usamgelo. I actually got into acting around 99, 2000. Other kids did karate, chess, whatnot. I did acting.
So my name is Zazi Kunene. I'll be playing Nolwazi in Jiva. Acting was just a way to express myself. I felt like I could become a character.
My name is Stella Dlangalala.
My character, Lady E, her main thing is Banzula. My passion for acting just helped me to get out of my shell.
Dun, dun, dun.
Oh, wow! I'm assuming that this is Uncle Zo's space. This looks very Uncle Zo. Wow. Humble beginnings. Looks so real!
Oh, my goodness. This is so amazing! Okay, so this must be the kitchen. This is like my South African home, guys. I feel like I'm at home.
Kibineta! This fridge, we know this bad boy. This is the one where you hush, hush the whole way. Hush, hush, to take the ice out now. Hush, hush.
This reminds me of my own home. This is so cute.
Passage. Let me see. I guess this is my room out here. Arr. Dope, dope.
And this is mine. Coco. This is gonna be my space.
Oh, I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it.
I'm gonna sit on my new bed. This is so exciting, oh my gosh.
With this project, we have Bunta Modisela, who is an amazing female smart choreographer. For me, she's the best female dancer in our country. She was doing this when we didn't even have bank accounts as dancers. You know what I mean? And she's still doing it up till today. And you have me, who is literally the core, the founder of what we call this Pooja, who is the person that was there when this whole movement grew and started and became bigger. And now you get to see the right people presenting it to the world.
Officially, here we are! Woo! I will no longer refer to you by your individual names, my friend, by your character names. So welcome, Lutron!
So
how I got Jiva, which is what we call dance in South Africa at home. We call it Jiva.
So I got the email, they're like, yo, there's a dance project happening in Cape Town and they want people who can dance and who can act as well.
Then I go read the brief. Okay. Butch, mother of the group, lesbian, all these things. I'm just like, hectic. I was auditioning for two roles. I was auditioning for Lady E, I was auditioning for Zinke, and I wasn't auditioning for my role, but for Ntombi, because I wasn't from the region that Ntombi is from, which is KZN. I did my dance routine and I gave it everything, you know. I was having fun with it. And as I left, I'm like, all right, guys. I take a glance at the director and I'm like, girl, you blew it. Because I came home like, yeah, it's character says by Butch, so I'm gonna be Butch. I'm like, ah, too strong. Bring it down. Take it down a notch, put the music on, and then... Everything is a blur. I don't know what I did, but I was out here, and I was doing all the things, and... Lume Bobby, all of the things. And they go, yeah! And I go, okay. I have a chance in this.
The audition process was amazing. It was fun. And then with the dancing, I was like, is this what's happening? Is it now? Do we have to do it now? I was tired. I was like, thank you. Thank you so much. They're like, good. Thanks, Umlazi.
So I remember I pulled up to the audition dressed like a Skotani, and I was like, yeah, this is me. So I practiced a few moves. I did the audition. It was pretty dope.
I auditioned initially for Umlazi, a child, again. They're like, okay, cool. You have a callback for Umlazi. I came to a callback for Umlazi. I'm like, no, okay, no kidding. We swear. Oh, the scripts, yo, shook me. I was like, yo. Oh, she's going through with this chick. Went to the casting, I cast it. I got called back 3 times. Yo, it was so painful, guys. When you just keep hearing, you're almost there, you're almost there, you're almost there. And I'm like, give up or not? I pull my agent, I'm like, have they said anything? No, okay. Have they said anything? No, okay. So I was like, okay, it's not mine. I'm not part of Jiva. Sad times, let it go. Something else will come. Get the call, I run down to the bathroom and I'm saying, what did you say? Repeat that. And she says, you're going to Cape Town. You are part of the Jiva, you are Lady E. And I just sat down there and I was like, thank you God. And I was just in tears.
I remember her calling me and she was saying, hi, Buiswa. And I'm like, you better stop. She's like, hi, Buiswa. And I'm like, wrong number, sis. And she goes, until you get it, Candace, hi, Buiswa. And she was like, congratulations.
I literally had just woken up. I And my mom had been praying every day for me from the first day we got the call. I'm like, yeah, you've been, congratulations, you've been accepted and for this role, da 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 da. You're gonna be playing Zinke. I was like, Jesus got me fire. Jesus got me, hit me.
She calls me, she's like, so we're gonna have like a party for our agency. And I was wondering if you're free. And then she's like, jokes, you might have to stay there in Cape Town because you got Netflix. I cried.
This Monday evening, I'm on my way to the airport and my agent gives me a call. She says, they want you. And I'm like, Zinhle Ntombi, like, and she's, they want to book you for Ntombi. This is a lead role in a Netflix series, and they want me. I think when it really hit me was as I'm packing, then I'm realizing that I'm actually going to Cape Town to start shooting this Netflix series. I'm at OR Tambo International Airport, heading to Cape Town for my first ever series. I'm so excited. I would have invited you guys into my room while I was packing, but I think you guys wouldn't have respected me. So I think maybe it's good that I didn't let you guys in. But I'm really excited and I'm about to go check in. So come along, let's go.
Packed and ready.
It's the day.
We are on our way to the airport now.
Woo! Let's do it.
Let's do it.
When I was packing, I was like, okay, I'm happy, I'm excited, this is huge, and I am going to enjoy it.
We get to Cape Town, we meet Scottness, and he tells us, like, this is huge. This is happening. So there was, like, this moment where we all just went, this is huge.
When I was walking in the studio, I was like, hey, I'm unfit, yo. I haven't been to the gym in a while, so this is gonna be interesting. So I was like, okay, let's start. And then Bonhle was hitting it. And I was keeping up.
My goodness, my legs, I work out. Like, I work out a lot. But that, I think maybe it was also the nerves.
There's so much choreography that we have to learn in such a short space of time.
These girls work so hard as dancers. They push themselves. I come from a small town called Gwasand. We weren't really exposed to the entertainment world. I mean, obviously we'd see it on TV, but the access wasn't there for us. So I always thought that dancing was gonna lead me to acting, which is true.
My first job was playing in The Lion King, and I was an ensemble member and also was supposed to be a Nala understudy. And well, that didn't work because, so I wasn't trained vocally. Classically trained. So when I got to London, I had a really hard time vocally, which then led to me not being able to play Nala, which was a bummer because every single night I watched Nala on stage and knew that I was not gonna be able to perform Nala.
And my granddad was prophetic about it because as a child, I used to dance in front of the TV, literally in this setting. I hope I don't get emotional about this.
and it literally looked like this, and I used to dance on the other side of the table.
When I came back home, I auditioned for Sarafina, and I got the lead role of Sarafina, so which was really great for me and for my confidence at the time, because I really had felt like I'm not a great performer.
The TV was literally there. My granddad used to be like, "Hey, come on alone. No, 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 get chatting and chatting. No, I was a villa corner. Corner, some mother, man. Yeah, I'm a loo. Yeah, I'm a peche." Which means, like, she's gonna be famous. This one is gonna make it. She's gonna be the one that we're gonna be watching on TV.
It's so crazy, like, how sometimes I doubt myself and what I can do. And then I get amazing things like this.
Jiva to me was not just another production that I was going to be working on. It's not just another series. I related with the character instantly. A whole lot more about her was me. And I was like, God, thank you. Today, I get to serve my purpose. At first, I didn't see my purpose anymore. And now, here I am, serving exactly what God wanted me to serve, where I get to connect with that other girl who's about to give up. And I'm telling her, Sisi Jiva, Vuka, Jiva, Manje. It does not end. It does not end. There's a whole other side to it. Jiva Sisi Zobon.
I can't hear you. Good afternoon. It's been a long day, but we're gonna get into Miles Davis says, it takes a long time for you to learn to play like yourself. So what we're gonna do today is we are going to play. We're gonna learn how to walk. We're gonna learn how to talk as our people. So to start us off,
imagining that you're kissing the other side of the room and then making the biggest smile. So kiss with your whole face and smile. And kiss. And smile. And let's get your body involved in that kiss and kiss. And smile. Another one and kiss. And smile. Oh, last one and kiss. And smile.
That bomb, bomb, bomb.
Okay, so like, I mean, that's interesting that we're going Shaka Zulu vibes, right? Because Shaka Zulu was probably one of the first, you know, pieces of content from the continent, depending on your point of view in politics, that is kind of grabbing our aesthetic and putting it in a way that the world can see. What was so dope about that, it wasn't just us. You know, people like in New York, they started the whole Shaka Zulu hip-hop nation.
Exactly.
In New York.
Shaka Zulu.
And that was our stuff and our aesthetics, yeah. Our culture that was informing global movements. And what's so dope about right now is that we are in that moment again, yes, with our dance.
Mm. It's beautiful to see Zulus, well, just Africans, different from boom, 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 yes, boom. And be like, yes, hey, they're creating some really cool things, yeah, that we like, you know? Yeah. Not just, hey, hi, da-da-da. You know what I mean? So yeah. I think it's nice to take it away from that as well.
I got into acting when I was in grade 3. I joined Helen O'Grady Speech and Drama Academy. So actually it was just to help me articulate, and because I was a shy baby, I couldn't speak in groups, and my mom was just like, I find that what's happening. So she sent me to the Speech and Drama Academy just to get me to break out of my shell.
I knew without a shadow of a doubt that it was more than just a pastime. When I watched Waza Albert, I was like, oh man, I will, if I can allow people to just experience that momentary suspension of disbelief and forget their woes and walk in and experience this just as I have, then I think my purpose in the world has been fulfilled.
I was very shy growing up and very insecure. I did a school play that was actually the end of the year function, and they said, just put something together as the grade sevens. And we just put something together, and apparently I was very funny because, like, all my peers were just laughing and saying, how did you do that? How do you think of that? So that's how it started. It was just a way for me to escape myself because I wasn't confident enough to be myself. So I went into characters and played other people to feel more confident.
I was like 4 or 5 years old. It was coincidental. When it started, my parents was, because I grew up in like Hillbro, I grew up in flats, and Hillbro wasn't the safest place to be around at that time. School holidays, my parents wanted something to keep me and my sister busy so we don't end up running around in the streets. So there's this famous kids program that used to like let kids come on the show during holidays, you know, play games. So my mom used to take us there like every single day, like we'd wake up early in the morning just to go there. Someone approached my mom and was like, hey, listen, your son seems very comfortable in front of the camera. Don't you wanna like get him an agent?
I think the turning point for me when I realized that this is serious for me was when how much I fought for it with my parents, because they just didn't understand it. And I think if it wasn't serious for me, if it wasn't a calling, if I wasn't passionate, I would have been like, well, you guys win. I won't do it. I'll do something else. Not having money, relying on your friends, can I come sleep over? Please borrow me money. All of those things, as you grow up, you go, I can't keep doing this. It gets very discouraging, and it also gets very lonely.
I went 18 auditions. I didn't get a single one. Advertisements, series, soapies, the whole shebang. I'm a praying woman. And God wouldn't give me all of this talent and this gift if it wasn't for the purpose of transforming the lives of others. It's all those no's that prepared me for the yeses. And I know that this experience could have only been my maker. And I've opened the first door, and I'm excited. From the character that I'm playing, I'm just so grateful.
My mom, she never caught that time. And these auditions were like in northern suburbs of Joburg, you know. She wasn't really familiar with these places. So that was like a lot of time she'd piggyback me to auditions. And then the taxi would drop us off like a kilometer away, and we have to walk like across the road. You know, like so many other parents were like, we don't understand why you do this. Like, you're wasting your time, you're wasting your money, taking taxis for it. Like, we don't even see where it's going.
I come from a home where my mom is unemployed, and it's a very small home, and this means so much. Even this project just means so much to my mother. So, whoa, let's not. So this means a lot to me. Sorry, I just lost my train of thought. Every time I think about my mom, it just gets really emotional. Cool. She's so amazing. She's so supportive. We didn't have much growing up, but I never felt it. I never felt like we didn't have much. Anything I needed, she would do whatever it takes to give it to me. Anything. We come from a place where Pietermaritzburg is a small place. It's a small town. That's where I'm from. And when you're given this platform and you're from a place like that, it's a huge thing. It's a huge thing.
Michael, so Miles Davis says, it took me a long time to learn how to play like myself. We've explored walking like ourselves.
now, and we'll just get in a circle, we're going to talk a little bit about learning to talk like ourselves. So we've got a responsibility. I'm just, because I want to give a couple of people different opportunity. We've got a responsibility to speak about the culture. Authentically.
I think we need to be as multi-representational as we possibly can, because this is created by South Africans for the world and to the world. And they can't afford to think once again that we're just this.
So it's so important for us to own this moment in time and be like, yo, this is who we are. This is what we sound like.
We get into these spaces, we feel so small. I'm 20 and everyone else in the cast is like older than me. So I feel like I'm sometimes so hard on myself. Often the space just swallows you up and you don't feel like you're worthy. And that is so sad. That is so sad because we're so talented. We just need to believe in ourselves. That's all.
The power of storytelling and the power of bringing performance to young people, older people, can really have a great impact. So I can't wait to learn more about Lady E. And as I said, it's my first TV thing, so I'm very nervous and I am capable. And it's gonna come together. When that thing goes action, it's go time. It's go time.
My inspiration from, I think it's probably from the older artists that I listen to and watch, especially listen to. So I like to think I'm an old soul. So I enjoy Letambulu, Tina Turner, Whitney Houston, Brenda Fassie sometimes, oh, Miriam Makeba. So I think because they had so much life in what they did, they lived their performances. You know, I think they were artists on and off stage. So the different genres that are in the story that we are telling, there'll be a whole lot of gom.
Gom is spelled G-Q-O-M, but pronounced gom. So if you even hear the pronunciation and how the word gom, you hear that ba, there's a ga, go, ga. If you hear it from anywhere, it's like a whistle. It's like, yeah, man, it's a catalyst for something bigger.
It's like a bang, like a bang. And the bang, like, you know how a drum always hits you here? And it hits you in your heart. That's what gom does.
And you can see how the world is catching on to its sound. If you have a song called Iwokepan.
It has been on the global stage. For goodness sake, Beyonce used it in an Instagram post of hers. Like, it's so dope when you get to hear yourself or see yourself reflected on an international stage or an international platform.
There'll be a whole lot of Amapiano, which are very new.
When you listen to Amapiano, Amapiano is very, you know, groovy, jazzy vibe. So that obviously grew from what we call house in our country. But, you know, it's a bit slow, it's not fast. And then now we have these lyrics that we have, that we sing at the in the hood, you know, when we party, you know. I was still on my number, phone, you know. It's, that's streets, that's strictly the streets, you know.
Yebo! Yebo!
So it's spansula, it's bojwa, upenga, piano is the last thing that we have now. And they are all different.
We're definitely going to be doing some traditional things. So there'll be a whole lot of
traditional music, Zulu, umbakanga. We'll be exploring those different genres of dance that we have here in South Africa.
Dance is a battlefield. It's a battlefield on so many levels.
Dance to me is, it's life for me, because it saved my life.
3 weeks before getting onto production to work, I had just given birth. So I'm a first-time mom, and I have a beautiful, beautiful baby girl. Understand that I'm in a very vulnerable place and space in my life, okay? So I'm doing all of this for the first time. I'm feeling it out. I'm working schedules out. I'm nursing. I am breastfeeding. Simultaneously, I'm thinking choreography, or I'm executing it, but not really fully. And here she is. And, you know, it's been a lot. It's been a lot. It's been heavy.
How do you guys feel by the progress? Are you guys okay with the pace that we're moving at? Because we've taken so long to get these two.
Yeah.
So I am worried, like, what's gonna happen now when we have to learn about 8 more pieces?
Honestly, now it's literally cleaning up while learning, because we're not gonna have time to break things down like we've been breaking them down. And I think that's where our headspace needs to get at, where we're picking things up the moment we're taught them.
And I just hope we are all mentally prepared.
Means so much to me, because I think if I was not dancing, then I'd have probably become a drug addict, or, you know, started abusing myself with alcohol, or I'd probably be in jail, maybe, I don't know, you know, because when you are going through so much, you start making funny decisions. I know how it feels to go to bed without food. I used to walk to school, which is like quite a distance. I remember my friends in my street organizing school clothes for me to go to school. In 2006, we started the group, and in 2007, I lost my dad. So my dad passed away in 2007. And then while I was, you know, getting over losing my dad, and then my mom passed away in 2008. What made it worse was that when they passed on, my family members, relatives, cousins fled. So everyone just disappeared, and I had to fend for myself, you know? And then I was taken into an orphanage. Yeah, so that was very hectic for me. I think up till today, it's the one thing that is difficult to overcome, you know? And I think what hurts me the most about it is that when they passed on, I mean, I was still in high school, so they never really got a chance to see me become a man.
I danced my way throughout my pregnancy. I didn't stop. And I didn't want to cheat myself of it. And I think too many women in pregnancy go through a very tedious, daunting, heavy process. And I didn't want that. I wanted to tell a different story. I wanted to live a different narrative. I wanted to be confident in my pregnancy. And I wanted to feel good about myself. I know one of the challenges for me, particularly on this project, is working with my sister. And it's a big challenge in the sense that I've got to be hard on her. I have to. I can't be lenient. There can't be any preferential treatment.
I auditioned, I went through the process just like any other person did. And it just so happened that this one spoke closest to me.
She isn't my sister in this space. She's Vuyiswa.
and I'm the choreographer.
Naturally, because of that, I'm just like, oh my gosh, I need to do it justice because of who my sister is, and I need to be great. And sometimes I look to her a little too long and a little too hard and be like, she gave me a nod. No, there's no nod. Oh my word, she doesn't think I'm amazing.
And you know, obviously, when the situation happened, it affected my self-confidence for a long time. You know, so the one place where you can tell me what to do, or you know, it's when I'm dancing, because that's where I forget of my problems. I forget if I'm heartbroken. It's the friend that God gave me that never judges me. You know. A place of vulnerability without worrying who's gonna say what, etc. So dancing is the love of my life.
African woman, I know how our stories do not seem valid in the eyes of the rest of the world. And to be able to take my culture and our stories and to be the ones that tell it is a treat and is exciting because it's going to be from our hearts.
Came into the process with like expectations and preconceived notions of who we'd be off of Instagram. But if I were to put our leading lady, Noxy, in one word, sum it up in one word, I think it would be determined. Determined. And it's probably what we get off of seeing you on Instagram. Mm-hmm. But I mean, yeah. And that's besides the point, really.
Yeah.
But you're determined. Mm-hmm. Fire, man. Oh,
man.
Fire.
Oh, man, are you gonna cry?
What I'm going to leave behind on this dance floor is my heart. I'm gonna leave behind any insecurity I ever had about my ability and my talent. I'm going to leave behind a stamp in the world that says, this is South Africa. This is Noxolo. This is what Noxolo does. I see myself building women and
making them take ownership of their bodies, and I'm definitely gonna leave my heart.
This is to my spirit animal, yo. This is to Stella.
Wow.
Because it inspires me. You are power.
Yes.
You're such power. Yes. Like you, your performances.
Yes.
Just when I see you, it's just.
Yes.
I remember telling my best friend that I just need one person to go, yes, I've been getting so many no's, and I just, one day someone's gonna go, yes. And Netflix, Scottness, Amanda, Bontle, Tom, they said yes.
It's happening.
This is real. This is real.
This is the time to be loud and bold and unapologetic. And I feel so grateful that I'm representing people my age in this time right now. It's such a beautiful time to be yourself.
It's gonna be so beautiful to see that, okay, here's Umlazi, and I've been through this. So if Umlazi could do it, I can speak about my problems. I don't need to feel ashamed about everything that I've been through. I'm not gonna question my position anymore, especially with this process. And it's so exciting.
I am going to choose Nembata. And the word I've chosen is confident. You are so beautifully confident. And it's so beautiful that you're the professional dancer here, but the way you inspire us, you've never made us feel like, oh, you guys, you don't really dance like all the time like me, you know? You have this big heart.
I think this whole experience is emotional for me because there's a point in my life where I just didn't see it going further than me performing as a dancer or as a choreographer and doing stages and being a backup dancer. I was starting to realize the weight on my shoulders that I had. There's a lot of dancers that I had promised and said, we're gonna change this industry is gonna respect us. This industry is gonna pay us what we deserve. I was starting to feel like I was failing the industry. I was failing those who were looking up to me and those whom I had promised that, you know, one day we're all gonna be respected like any other 9-to-5er.
Candace, ooh, this is hectic, but because you're so colorful as well, like, I think you are the informative one. Whether it's dance, whether it's music, you know so much, you take time to do your research, you take time, like, you can tell that you're graduates. You're the graduates.
And all is said and done, I would have hoped to leave on the Jiva stage my greatest insecurities, because I've come in with so many of them. If anything at all, I want to leave with pride that I did my level best to represent South Africa and Africa the best I possibly could on a global platform. But collectively, we could leave a legacy behind. This is a time capsule that is going to be archiving South Africa's narrative from our lens, from our voices, from our stories and our truth. And we are so selfless about gifting the world with that.
Root boy, steal that combo.
No bunga ngi dini kabo the mystery. No bunga fagi pende ne lace the mystery. No bunga ti browse on flick the mystery. No bunga mi kana next week the mystery. I'm but chasing guni when I'm a code. Kem na ke tomba me la pendi. I'm but chasing guni when I'm a code. Kem na ke. Don't bamba la penji, don't bamba la, don't bamba.